Hey, what's going on, guys? Killscope here, and welcome to my spoiler-free review of Jessica Jones. Jessica Jones is the newest series in a four-part series of Marvel superheroes. The first one, which was Daredevil, which came out earlier this year in April, which was a huge hit. And it's a four-part series because there's going to be a new TV show, I don't know when, probably 2 or 3 years down the line from now. It's called The Defenders, and basically each of these characters from The Defenders is getting their own TV show. So Daredevil got his, and then the next is Jessica Jones, then it's Luke Cage and Iron Fist. Those four people and a Punisher make up The Defenders, and overall I have to say it's an incredible series. You know, there's a lot of people talking about it, and it's like Daredevil, but at the same time it isn't. It has its own elements which helps it stand out from other TV shows. It's nice to see have a female protagonist instead of a male protagonist. We know we've gotten a lot of those, and it just brings a nice, fresh, new perspective. Again, the show is also set in Hell's Kitchen, just like Daredevil. I'm pretty sure all of these, you know, Iron Fist and Luke Cage will also be set in Hell's Kitchen. Definitely Luke Cage. I'm not sure about Iron Fist yet. And so I never really knew much about Jessica Jones before the TV series. You know, I didn't even know that was a character. And once I found out the series was coming out, I was really excited for it. And they do a lot of really, really similar things to what Daredevil did. But at the same time, they do their own things. Like, one of the things that helped this show stand out, which isn't really anything major, it does play a role in this story of Jessica Jones, but it's not something that, like, I was like, oh, that's awesome. You know, I'm just like, oh, it's nice to see that on television. Which was, there's actually a lesbian relationship in the show. And I'm not going to say who it is. It's not Jessica. It's with some other people in the show. And, you know, I think it's nice that they're doing that because it really shows that, you know, we're not afraid to show this kind of stuff on television. It's normal stuff now. You know, it's not something that's, like, weirding people out. But I think it's nice that they're starting to show that on television. I know Gotham does that, too. And then the next thing that I really liked about the show is the characters. You know, each of the characters is different, and I'm not sure how well Jessica is portrayed in comparison to the comics in the show, but I think taking it from the source material, so I'm pretty sure it's very accurate. Luke Cage is pretty much spot on. You know, he's got all of his elements right. His personality, his powers. It's one of the things I really liked about the series that they brought in Luke Cage. I wouldn't say as a cameo, it's more of like a part-time appearance. You know, he showed up in almost half of the series, and it was just really great, you know, because that really gets me hype and a lot of other people hype for his series, because it shows that, you know, Luke Cage's series has potential. The way it's playing out in Jessica Jones, he can definitely have his own standalone series and he'll be perfectly fine. What I really like is the chemistry between Jessica Jones and Luke Cage. You know, they're friends, they're more than friends. But it's just the way the chemistry plays out. You know, it's a very on-again, off-again relationship, and it was just nice to see. Also, fair warning, the show is not for kids. You know, the first few episodes, well, I'd say probably like the first 4 or 5 episodes, it's just sex. It's just sex and alcohol, that's about it. But it's still like, there's still some other stuff. Next thing that I really liked in the show is the villain. The villain Kilgrave. He has the power to control people with his... just by saying stuff to them. So if he says something like, oh, I'll go kill yourself, you know, they'll do it. I think it was nice that it brought in a different type of villain. I was a little bit worried in the beginning. I'm like, how are they going to play this out? And they played it out pretty well. You know, there were some little flaws with it. I was like, that could have been done better, or that wasn't needed. But overall, he was a pretty good villain, you know. I think he makes a pretty good first villain. But I would definitely give kudos to Daredevil for that. You know, they nailed it. I did like the little relation that was between Jessica and Kilgrave. You know, they had a relationship before, and then the way the chemistry plays it between the two is great. You know, the beginning she was with him, and then she left him for reasons, and now she basically just wants to kill him. And it's just there's a whole story behind it, and it's great. You know, the one thing that was a little bit different that they did from Daredevil is the way that they give a background on the main villain, you know. I remember in Daredevil, they did an entire episode, or a little more than an entire episode, to the villain, you know, just talking about his background, like where he came from and what's his deal, how he became like that. And this, it's like they break it down into bits and pieces over a certain amount of episodes, over like 3 or 4 episodes, we get a good background of like who the character is and how he came to be. And I think that was nice. You know, it works just as well as what Daredevil did with just an entire episode. It works just as well, so I really like that. Overall, this show is not very like action heavy. It does have action, and Jessica Jones does have superpowers, but it's not, you're not gonna get that same like, she's not getting like beating the shit out of people like every single episode. Well, she does, but you don't see as much of that as you would in Daredevil. So it's not like a complete brawler type of TV show. You know, there's, she's a private investigator, so there's a lot of like crime elements that play out in the show. So I really like that, and that really helps the show stand out more. As for season two, I definitely think the series has potential for a season two, maybe even a season three, depending on how well things play out. I think there's a showrunner that confirmed that the second season won't be happening until after Defenders. So that's probably not for another like 3 or 4 years, maybe even more. But that's all I have for this review, Jessica Jones. If you've seen it, leave a comment down below. Let me know what you guys think about it. If you enjoyed the series, smack that like button. And if you like anything else on my channel, then feel free to subscribe. See you guys next time.